Hi guys, so this will be a WordPress tutorial and I'm going to show you how you can create custom post types into your WordPress website. So regardless of the themes, this should work. So let's say for example, you want to add a project section or a podcast section, then you need to register a custom post types. So there's an option for you to do that. You can use a plugin or you can also put a code into your Functions.php. So if you want to create a specific fields or section into your WordPress admin, let's say for example it's a podcast or a press release section, you need to have or you need to register a custom post type. And there's two options for us to do it. So we can do it via plugin and we can also manually register it on our functions.php. I'm going to show you the two processes so you have an options like whichever setup you want. So for the plugin, the advantage of that is super easy to configure and it's only like it's very understandable, but the only disadvantage of that is it will add you another file or a bandwidth because you are installing a plugin. But type of a person that you want to minimize using a plugin, then the manual registration will work for you. Okay, so now let's start on the first option, which is using a plugin method. Okay, to do that, type in custom. So type in custom post type. And then you will see this one called custom post type UI. You can also use the other plugin, but make sure that it has the highest installation, or at least it has a highest installation, a good rating, and the compatibility as well should be good. Okay, and I'm gonna use this plugin, so activate, and then let's go in this part called CPT UI, and then you have like an options in here. Let's say we will add a podcast. So podcast. You can also make it. You can also make it singular and plural, and then you have also like an options in here that you need to configure, and this is very self-explanatory. As you can see in here, there is some examples that you can follow along, so just scroll down in there, and then in this part as well you can have like, if you want this to like in this support, add support values for available post editor, a check volume means the post type is featured or supported. So if you want to add an excerpt or a revision for your post type, so revision is really important in pages. So I would say I will add a revision for the custom post fields. Maybe we can use custom post fields as well, and then add a post. Okay, and as you can see in here, there is already a custom post type for your episode. Now, if you want to delete this one, so simply go to the add and edit post type, and go to the edit post type or view post type rather, and let's say, actually, edit post type. And we will delete this one, for example. So just select the drop down thing and then edit. So if you want to change this, you want to change information, just click the drop down and that. Now, so what if you don't want to use a plugin and you want to, you know, minimize using a plugin as much as possible? So in order to do that, you need to register your custom post type into your function.php. But before anything else, you need to make sure as well that you have a child theme. And if you don't have a child theme yet, I do have a tutorial for that that you can check out. I will put it on the link description below for more information. So once you already have a child theme, go to the appearance and then themes and theme editor. And then you go to your child theme and go to the functions.php. And then we need to register our custom post type. So I will go to the custom, let me go to the WordPress documentation. So I just want to explain with you first, before we put all the codes that we have, so everything have sense with you guys. So let's type in custom post type, okay? And then go to the developer's documentation, and then let's look this reference, because we want to register a custom post type into our function.php. Most of the code or the syntax you really need can be found on the reference or the documentation in WordPress. So yeah, so when you go in here, like if you scroll down more there, you can see the list of arrays that you can use, and some examples as well, okay? So let's scroll down in here and you will see this part, I believe. You can see this. Others have some logical functions, but we just want to really create a simple custom post type. So this one is, should be fine. Let me try. I'm just scrolling it up. So this one should be fine. Okay. And all of these arrays for the labels, it's not really necessary for you to work on those. You can remove some of the elements if you don't want to set the name. But yeah, how you can first is, I just want to explain with you first. So first is, you need to have a function word and then the name of your functions. And then these are the labels that you can put on your functions.php and argument for the array. So the syntax is a function, and then you need to have a labels inside and an array. And then you need to register your array as well. So register underscore post custom post type. The name of the array, it depends on you, what would be the name you want. And then arguments, okay? So argument. Lastly is, you need to add a filter. You need to add a hook, which is add action in it, and the name of the functions. So this one, okay? You can also put this add actions above the functions.php. Now I will paste the functions that I created. I pasted rather. So basically, like some of the fields in here, I've already removed because I don't think those are necessary. But these are so far, and I also love to put the add actions in it in here. And yeah, so if we update this one, you'll notice, if we refresh this one, you will see a press custom post type in here. So again, the custom post types needs a child theme. So if you're not familiar with the child theme, then I have a tutorial for you in that. So just check the link description below or in here for more information.